It's your girl Deja. Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new to my channel, welcome to my channel. I will be giving out the biggest advice I could ever give to you guys about being captain. It's really important because nobody ever talks you through the role of having all these girls to watch. Like, nobody ever tells you, oh, you need to do this or you need to do that, but I'm here for y'all, so let's get into this video. First of all, being a captain is not easy. It's not easy at all. Everybody, it's all hype. Honestly, it's all hype. It's a big, big commitment that you have to like set, because it's not an easy thing to do. Being a captain with the girls, like a team over 27 girls or 12 girls, even 12 girls, it's still a lot of work, because females will be females. A team will be a team. There will be conflicts. There will be bad days and good days. But as a captain, there are certain things that you have to make sure you have under control. Like, you have to know when everybody is on their period. Like, I'm being so serious with you guys. Like, you just have to know, because the vibes, all of that is in your control. People coming into practice with the same positivity is in your control. If you come to practice as captain and you negative and you sad and you upset, it's gonna reflect on your girls. They're gonna have a bad practice because of your energy, what you're putting out. So like, it's not easy. It's not easy. You have to know how to control your emotions first before you can control others' emotions. You cannot be a lazy captain. If you're a lazy captain, you're gonna have a lazy, sloppy team. You have to put the energy you put into yourself into your team. When you were telling yourself, oh, I wanted to be the best, oh, I wanted to do this for myself, you have to tell your team, y'all gonna be the best, because I'm not a mess. Like, I know my worth, so y'all have to know y'all worth. Like, you have to motivate these girls. You're the big, like, you're the pedestal for them. Like, you have to put yourself up there. You have to hold yourself on that level. You have to carry yourself on that level. No rumors about you. If there's rumors about the captain, there's gonna be rumors about the whole team. Like, honestly, it's just a role that it takes a lot of work. And it's, everybody doesn't accept it and everybody doesn't do it right. That's why they have so much dysfunctional teams. But you know, a team is a team. Y'all have the same cycles around each other. Stuff go off sometimes, okay? It's gonna happen. But as captain, you have to know how to control that. You have to know how to talk to your girls. You also have to know how to be serious. When it comes to times that y'all have to work, you have to know how to be mean. Not mean to like hurt their feelings, but mean to like, I'm trying to get the best out of you, so I need you to cooperate. Like, you really have to shut down your goofy mode and go into boss mode. Like, it's just a serious effect, and it really will help out your team, because if y'all goofy all the time, y'all ain't gonna get no work done. Especially when there's conflicts, you have to know how to not pick sides. You have to let them know what they both did wrong. It has to be a collective thing so they don't do it again. Because if the other girl feels like, oh, you taking sides, oh, I don't want to be on your team no more because you don't like me and this and that. Like, you really have to be a people's person, and you have to know how to communicate. Even if it's somebody you honestly don't like or somebody you honestly don't get along with, if she's essential to the part of your team, you have to know how to settle the issue. It's your team. They're built around you. But you also have to know how to not overuse your power. Because you're captain doesn't mean you could talk to people any kind of way. Doesn't mean you could bring your teammates down because you're on a higher pedestal. That's not what the captain role is. You are equal to your girls. You want them to be the same as you. So you don't push them down. You don't make them feel bad about themselves. You're supposed to uplift them. Because it just, that's not how cheerleading is supposed to work. You're not supposed to be like, oh, I could do this better than you, that's why I'm this. Like, that's not good. You have, everything has to be shared equally. For you to have a really strong team, you have to be able to understand each girl on your team and each of their skills and each of their weaknesses. You just have to understand them. But you just make sure you communicate. That's all it takes. Thank you for watching. And if you have not watched the rest of my videos, you could click on the screen or you could click down below and the links will be right there for you, okay? Make sure you like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.